Hey guys, it's KEVINVANDY, and welcome back to another video in my PowerDirector 16 tutorial series. In this video, I'll be showing you how to use the Chroma Key feature, or as you might call it, the green screen feature. Now, I actually made a video about this a few years ago, and it became the most popular video on my channel with over 200,000 views. But now that we're on PowerDirector 16, a few of the buttons have changed, and I also just want to do a more in-depth tutorial this time. Now with that out of the way, let's get started exploring the Chroma Key feature. Now we need to remember how the timeline works. So if you recall, whatever we put on the very first track will be the most bottom layer on our video canvas here. Which meaning that if we put an image on a lower track at this very same time, this one will show on top of the one on the first track. So this is on top, this is on bottom. Now that's important in green when we're trying to do chroma key, because if we want whatever has our green screen or the color we want the chroma key out to be on the very top, right? And then we want our whatever we want in the background to be on the first track. Now I can actually do an example here with the chroma key on these two images here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to just chroma key out black. Usually we chroma key out green when we're talking about green screen, but you can do it with any color actually. So I do it with black. Now first what you need to do, click on the image so it brings up all these tools. And we'll go to Designer and the Picture-in-Picture Designer. So that brings up the Picture-in-Picture Designer edit menu. And here's the chroma key. Now you want to expand this so that we have all the options here. And actually, since this is what the color we want the chroma key out is black, all we have to do is just enable chroma key because the default color that it chroma keys out first is black. So if I just enable it, there, it's done. We've got a nice image here. Now we can resize this and drag it around and put it wherever we want. And I'll replace the sun. And we've got a kind of cool image here. It doesn't make too much sense, but it looks kind of cool. Now let's move on to an actual green screen. I'll move that all the way over here. Here's the green screen clip I want to use. Now we're going to want to put the footage that has the green screen on the second track, and we want to put the background in the very first track. And first, before I get started, I want to lower this volume. Now, we have clicked on this video. Now we're going to Designer and the PIP, or Picture-in-Picture Designer. Now we're going to do the same thing. We've enabled it, but now we need to change it. Instead of black, we want it to be this exact color green. Now what we do to make it change it to green is click the eyedropper and then click anywhere that has the color you want the chroma key out, and there we go. We've got a let's see how well it turned out. We'll play it.
It's time to stop!
And that worked pretty well. But, see, it worked really well just because the color of green we used was very, very green and very consistent. Now, let's see what happens if we have a green screen, maybe that's not too perfect. As we can see in this video clip I have here, it's barely green. When I shot this, and we only had a slightly green wall. We didn't have a green screen available, but you can still get it to work decently well in PowerDirector. So let's try this video clip. Now we're gonna do the same thing. Open up all this stuff. We're gonna enable it. It's black. Now we're going to change it to green, or, well, this color of green, whatever it is. And it doesn't actually look too good.
I'm Caleb Johnson.
See, it's really blocky. So what we're going to do is first we're going to push up the edge sharpness. That actually really helps get rid of the blocky artifacts. Then we're going to adjust the tolerance of hue if you give it a little bit more of a color range. You can see that up here as I adjust this, this gets wider. It's including more colors to chroma key out. You don't want to go too far though, because it'll start chroma keying out some skin color, and I don't want to do that. I'm going to probably keep it below 30, about 25. tolerance to saturation, I've experimented, it doesn't really have much effect on this particular color of green. But who knows what you're working with. You really just need to play with everything and see what works the best for you. I'm going to put the tolerance of luminance up a bit. Although you don't want to go too much again, because it'll start cutting off the edges around here. So actually I'll put that down a little bit more. And I guess that's a good spot, and I think that looks pretty good. Let's see how it turned out.
I'm Caleb Johnson, and I approve this message.
That seemed to work pretty well. See, we didn't have that good of a green screen, we're still able to make it work in PowerDirector. Now, one of the last things I want to show you is you can have multiple green screen tracks. And what I mean by that, like, you can put green screens on top of green screens. So here, for an example, we put this here. Let's see. Let's have a little bit of fun with this. So you can see we have our bottom layer, which is this background. Then we have a second layer on top of the background, which is our Caleb Johnson here, running for president. And then we have a third layer here of another green screen. So you can get crazy with this and do a bunch of stuff. Let's see how this turns out.
I'm Caleb Johnson. And I approve this message.
It's time to stop!
I was born
it's time to
in
stop,
the heartland
okay?
of the United States.
No more!
That works pretty well. And with that, I think I'm going to bring this tutorial to an end. I think it's about time to stop. And if you found this video tutorial helpful, it always helps if you leave a like. And if you have a question, leave it in the comments. I actually usually try to respond to comments within the day or two that you post it. I think I read pretty much every comment I've gotten on my channel before, so chances are I'll be able to answer it. And if you want to see a video I made, I guess it was 3 years ago, of like the finished product of this bad green screen footage, you can see just how crazy you can go with PowerDirector. And I'll see you guys in the next PowerDirector tutorial.